school was on the second floor of the original building, and the convent was on the third floor. The nuns lived on the third floor.
I taught in the bungalow days here in 2024, I think it was. I couldn't even go through the aisles. I had to turn sideways to go through the aisles. We had 40, 50 students in one room. So we had a glorious time that night. We rolled up our bedding and carried it across from Windsor to this convent. We tried out every bed. We just had a picnic that night because it was so much fun to come to a big house like this. We just thought we had everything at that time. We tried the dumb waiter. We had one of those things that you could, from the basement on up to the third floor. So we tried that, and we just tried everything possible. We had a glorious time. The next morning, we went to church and closed the doors. We didn't take the keys, and here we were. We were all locked out. We couldn't get back in.
The tuition at Our Lady of Victory was really stiff. It was a dollar a month for every child.
And Father Frank would announce on the Sunday before school, if anybody couldn't afford to pay the dollar, should come to the rectory, and he'd help them out.
Later on, when my six kids went through here, it was only $2.
We always had to go to Mass. We had to go to Mass every day. And if the weather was very, very bad, snowy, rainy, whatever, usually it was after Mass that we would go back to the classrooms, but instead of making us walk on the outside, we would walk through the certain door, underneath the ground, into the tunnel. I guess it was the furnaces and everything else. We went past all these things, and then we came out, and there we were, right in the school, and we were nice and dry, never had to worry about wet feet or wet clothes or anything else. It was fun.
And you know, the clubhouse wasn't sided, and on the side, you would step down, and that's where they had the candy. They sell candy.
Oh, candy. I'll never forget, and it was a penny.
Yeah, we didn't necessarily buy what we like. We buy whatever you get the most of.
Absolutely, absolutely.
My first introduction to Our Lady of Victory School and to the School of Sisters of St. Francis was on a September day in 1950. The building at the semi-new building at Laramie and Agatite was only a year old, and we were escorted into the most beautiful kindergarten that had ever been created. It occupied almost the entire first floor of that new wing, and Sister Leah was its empresario or empress, and she welcomed probably over 100 of us. We had morning kindergarten and afternoon kindergarten, and what a wonderful, wonderful introduction to Catholic education Sister Leah was.
I started in first grade, and I really enjoyed it because of the nuns that were here teaching. A few of the nuns were very sweet, and a few of the nuns were very, very, very strict. I felt that I had a diversity of both gentleness and strictness in my life. And my religious background is the foundation of what I am today.
Wanted blue pants with a white stripe. We got white pants with a blue stripe. And every time I got grass stains on the pants, my mother would wash them, and I'd tell my mother, "You make me look like I didn't play."
I go back to the time when junior high building opened up. My sister Mary Pat was in the first eighth grade class there, and I was in the first seventh grade class. When we would have gym class, of course the boys were separate from the girls. They couldn't take gym class at the same time, but a lot of the sports that started didn't start till later in the 60s after we had graduated.
We were allowed to become cheerleaders in 1968, 69. which was big because then we got to go into the gym. The girls were not allowed in the gym before then. And this was our uniform. We had just this sweatshirt and our uniform skirt, which was blue.
I've been on the council for about 10 years now, and I'm involved with the Holy Name in respect that they contribute everything for us to run the athletics in this school. They are a wonderful organization. The men get together, have their fundraisers, and provide our sports programs with everything we need, and no other school in the city can say that. And we've had some great teams over the years, some great kids, some great coaches, and it's been my pleasure to work with such a fine organization, with the Sports Council as well as the Holy Name.
Attendance was taken in church at Mass. You had to be there. Was it by the end of the gospel or whatever?
Yeah, every day.
The beanies.
With our beanies on.
5 cents if you didn't have your beanie.
That was before my time. I saw.
You know, and then the clicking.
You know. Yes.
That's the way, the sister's way of getting our attention
if we weren't behaving.
We weren't behaving, you know. The.
The band leader we had at the time, or band director, started a marching band. We also had a jazz band for a grade school group. They were wonderful.
The school board was very archaic at that time. You couldn't speak out of turn. You had to be on the agenda. And if you weren't on the agenda, you couldn't say a word. But eventually that all changed, thank goodness. To Father Nolan, he changed it.
I appreciate the quality education I received at Our Lady of Victory School. One of my favorite teachers was Miss Harla Kapp, and she helped to inspire me to become an educator myself.
I was a lunch mom all through the years my daughters were at OLV. And Robin was like a mom to these children, and she was so caring about them, cared about their safety. I rarely saw her have to scold a child. She really treated all the children as if they were her own.
You have a question about anything that's ever happened in here, you go to Claire Spitzer. She can tell you anything you want to know.
Cluida came in, and she's the one that hired me, and I worked for her till she retired, and then we had our first lay principal, and it was a man, which was a real difference, and a young man.
We believe that it was really the sisters when they came in, and when our oldest son was in the junior high, he was just entering sixth grade. And that really galvanized their faith and taught us how to teach our faith to our children. And they're the ones that really inspired, I think, my oldest son and my middle son to join a seminary.
That was one of the first things that struck me as I was walking down the hallways with Sister Mary Sarah, was all of the different murals and things that were added to the walls in the school. And I thought, you know, they were such a beautiful addition to just the regular old painted wall that you remember from years back.
And a lot of the religious icons were added, which was very important too. Many of them had been taken down or were found broken in storage rooms. And a lot of them were restored and added once again to the school, which is really important to identify us as a Catholic school.
people were invited no matter what year they had graduated from OLV. And at the time, the Dominican sisters were here from Nashville, Tennessee, and they were a very big part in getting this party. It was a huge event. People were involved from the school to the parish to all the clubs and organizations. Everybody had a part, did their part. I remember Sister Sarah being worried that enough people, you know, would show up, and we ended up having 500 or 600 people, a huge mass on a Saturday evening at 5:30. And I remember because I was a Eucharistic minister, and it was so nice to see many of my classmates come back and return from the year that I had graduated.